What's up, everybody? This is Eric the Tech Preacher from Easy Computer Solutions. So I got the Moto G Stylus. And in this video, I'm gonna test out the cameras and see what it's all about. Now, this is a $299 phone. So the expectations of this camera is not high. Before I get this video started, I wanna go over the camera app. So I'm going to open up the camera app and I'm going to kind of go over it so we can see what kind of features that it has and things that it doesn't have. So this device can shoot up to 4K, right? Yes, it can shoot up to 4K. Also, the photo size kind of wearied me a little bit. Since this is supposed to be a 48 megapixel camera, I guess it got a lot of pixel bending going on here. But the photo size, as you can see, the rear camera photo size is 12 megapixel camera, 48 megapixel camera, quad pixels, what they're doing right here with the quad pixels. Again, I'm going to shoot this in 1080p. They do have slow motion up to 120 frames per second. Also, if you shoot in HD, which is 720p, you can shoot up to 240 frames per second. As far as the selfie camera, it looks like you can shoot 4 megapixel camera, 16 megapixel camera, quad pixels. Also, you can shoot at full HD, which is 1080p, and you can do cinematic 19:9 aspect ratio if you like. In photo mode, you can do portraits, cutout, macro shots, because it does have a macro camera on here. You can do spot color, night vision, cinemagraph, panorama, live filter, and stuff like that. In the video recording mode, you get macro, you get slow-mo, time-lapse, and AR stickers. So in this video, I'm going to shoot 1080p, 60 frames per second, and some clips, I'm going to slow it down 40% so I can get that slow-motion cinematic look. Also, I'm going to give you some still footage. I'm not going to do no color grading or anything like that. So all the footage that you're going to see in this video is coming straight out of the camera. And let's see what it's all about. Sit back, relax, and get your popcorn ready. And follow me on this journey. Let's go. That's how I got that heat. Let's go. Alright guys, so this is the front facing camera of the Moto G Stylo. Alright, and here it is, right? Front facing camera. I'm telling you, I'm looking at the viewfinder and it looks really good. The details look really good. And I mean, I'm just holding the device and I mean, wow, I am blown away of this front facing camera so far. But I've had to get it on the computer and see how good it is. But so far, it looks really good. You know, when you got these budget devices, a lot of people have low expectations. And I mean, by so it, you do have low expectations. But when you get the device and it do a really good job, I mean, it is what it is, right? And as you can see, as I turn around, I get it a little darker and the background highlights start to get a little lighter. I mean, that's expected because it's in auto mode. Now, some of the things that this device does not have is pro mode. Another thing that this device doesn't have is as far as object tracking. Just say if you
want to do portrait mode on the object. You can't do that. You can only do portrait mode on people. And that's unfortunate. So if I wanted to take a photo of a plant or a photo of something and I want to get that blur effect, the device tells me it does not see any faces or anything like that. So at the end of the day, this is what you get for, you know, $300. I mean, you don't expect too much out of a $300 device, but so far so good. And I'll see if y'all, let y'all guys see some of this stuff here. I mean, the colors look really good. I'm looking at the viewfinder. It looks really good. I don't know how it's gonna look once I get it on the computer, but this is why I make these videos, so y'all can be the judge for yourself when looking at these camera videos that I do. It's not for me to judge, it's for you to judge. This is Eric from Easy Computer Solutions. Leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think about the Moto G Stylus in all its glory. See you guys on the next video. Peace.